So I think.
Well, good evening, everybody, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to be here, and I'm sure we all are going to witness great hairdressing event today. Yeah, you're saying something.
Yes. So I think what probably Rajat is hinting at, he would like to, or rather, all of us would like to know, how was your journey from being a barber to a famous hairdresser?
Okay, from being a barber to a famous hairdresser. Well, both are different terms, you know. The barber is a barber, hairdresser. It's actually in the same family. So, you know, a lot of people think barbers is a very old school way of doing hairdressing, but barber is actually a beard job, what people used to do in, you know, ancient days. And in today's time, people consider barbers as who do men's hairdressing. Now, when I was a kid, I started my journey when I was 16 years old. I started doing professionally, you know. And when I was 9 years old, my father passed away, and my father was a hairdresser. And my mom used to always tell me, well, what do you want to be, you know? You want to be a hairdresser, or you want to do something else? Because, you know, during my time, in 1993, 92, I'm talking about, when people used to look down on hairdressing, they used to think, okay, you know, if this guy wants to be a barber, you know, people are going to look down at me. But when I went to college, you know, everybody wanted to be an actor, or doctor, or engineer. But for me, you know, I tried doing some theater in college, and I used to do a lot of theater. But you know, somehow it was not me, and I started doing hairdressing at home. And you know, there was not enough school. You know, I used to practice at home, and I used to do a lot of. You know, my friends used to be my guinea pigs. You know, I used to do, you know, whacked out hairstyles. You know, sometimes I used to do a very patchy job. You know, there used to be a lot of shadows in the hair. But I used to always tell them, this is looking really cool, you know. So that confidence I used to build in them, that this is fashion, and, you know, I used to somehow try to ego boost them, you know. So, yeah, but there's nothing in this field, you know, where you can't do it. So education is very important. For me, I traveled a lot. You know, I was sponsored by companies to travel to learn under famous hairdressers, and by the age of 18, 19, I was quite famous in my little area, where people used to think, okay, this guy is a very cool hairdresser who gives funky haircuts. And then gradually it started building up. You know, I started building up a team, then I started teaching others, then we formed an academy where we teach people. And if you see in last 10 years, if you see in India, there are a lot of iconic hairdressers. It's not only one, you know, every salon has got at least 15, 20 iconic hairdressers who's taking their brand ahead. And I'm very proud to be associated with Indian hairdressing, you know, where I see brands growing, becoming stronger, you know, they're giving birth to really, really nice, talented hairdressers who are very different, who are individual in their style, who have their own style. So that's how they're becoming brand. My many friends are here, like Awan, Savio, Aisha. They are deadly hairdressers. You know, I've seen their work. I get inspired looking at their work. You know, I learn from my juniors. If you come to my salon, you will see me looking at my juniors' work and learning from them. So all these young hairdressers are very, very talented. It's all about how you sharpen yourself, how you do your packaging, and how you sell yourself. That is very, very important. So barbering is all about that. It's not only male grooming. It's about how you're selling fashion, how you creating new iconic hairstyles. Because what happens when you're learning something, you copy paste. Okay, this is in, sides are burst, we have to create two lines, and this is looking cool. But that's not cool. Unless until you do something cool, different and iconic, then you're gonna be a head turner. If you're just copying, you know, two lines and button hairstyles, and you look like Indian cricket team, where, you know, all are looking like Xerox copies of each other. Everybody has got a beard, everybody has got buzzed hair and two lines. So for me, that's not fashion. So whatever you create, do something of your own, you know. In the starting, some people might not like it, but it will grow. So you have to be rebel in yourself. So that is very, very important. I was always a rebel, and I'm going to be a rebel. So that is very important in life. Well, to cut it short, let's start about today's event. Indian School of Hairdressing has been training students in the field of hairdressing. The school has earned a reputation for excellence and quality of hairdressing. Someone said something? ISH and BBA collaboration will launch a groundbreaking training tool for elite hair professionals and barbers, providing education which will cover all the fundamentals and obviously advanced techniques as well. Well, today we are going to talk about two gentlemen who are legends. They have achieved a lot in their own field. They are celebrated hairdressers. Now, it takes a lot to become a celebrated hairdresser because there's a lot of hard work, there's a lot of image building. You have to really work on your craft. You have to take breath every day because whatever you have done, you have to forget. Every day is a new day for you, new journey for you, because you have to create something, not to do something which you have learned. You have learned, you have done it, it's over. Now do something new. So I would like to speak about two guys, Chris and Eric. Eric Lander is one of Britain's best hairdressing and barbering educators. With over 30 years of experience in hairdressing, delivering seminars around the globe, coming from a family of hairdressers, you know, that has given him a very secure and strong base. This base has provided him an underpinning for the education of craft, which he has obviously expanded with his continuous professional education. Chris Foster, with more than 20 years experience, Chris is associated with BBA as a creative director and is considered as a leading player within the male hairdressing industry. His unique stance incorporates traditional barbering with a modern flair, ensuring a constant delivery of fresh and innovative ideas to men's hairdressing. His distinctive approach to male grooming is evident in example of remarkable contribution as a creative director of the Mayfair, as a creative director of the refinery in Mayfair, as well as the Harrods barbershop in central London. A big round of applause to Eric Lander and Chris Foster, guys.